We've just listed off some strategies for that be prepared from the instructor perspective. Now, how can we best prepare our students so that they have a smooth experience learning online? What we suggest is setting ground rules for communication and how sessions are structured. Here are a few concrete examples. Number one, set a rule for your students on how they can best let you know if they won't be attending a live session or coming a little late for whatever reason. For instance, at Chiron, we have them posted in the asynchronous Google Classroom so our instructors see it before they enter the session. Number two, decide together with your students how to best ensure that everyone gets to participate and not only a certain few dominate the sessions. At Chiron, we encourage more advanced students to support as facilitators, for instance, because we have a lot of diversity in our online sessions. Number three, go over where what type of communication takes place. For instance, content-related discussions outside of live sessions can take place in a forum or in Google Classroom, but preferably not in both. It's good to know where what type of communication is happening. And announcements regarding logistics and administration can maybe be done via email or Slack or another direct communication channel. But again, it's really important to decide ahead which one. It can get very overwhelming when students have lots of different fora and platforms that they have to communicate on. And at Chiron, we have that case where we have multiple platforms for our students: MOOC, Google Classroom, Google Hangouts Meet. Some of these ground rules you may determine alone as an instructor, whereas others may be more effective if they are determined together with your students so that there is buy-in and shared understanding. That way, students also feel that they are the creators of their learning environment and will take a role in enforcing those rules along with you. Once the ground rules have been determined, they should be written down and posted in a place accessible to all so they can be referenced back to. In general, the more you work on a structure beforehand, the easier it will be to focus on the most important aspect of your role. At Chiron, our instructors are volunteers, so we provide them with tutorial guidelines that structure the content of each session. This gives them more space to focus on pedagogical aspects and being present as a facilitator, instead of dealing a lot with preparation or with coordination. Now let's move on to P number two, be perceptive. While hosting a session on Google Hangouts Meet or another video conferencing system, you may find yourself in the situation at some point where you're asking yourself, huh, it's pretty quiet here. Are the students even still listening? In the online setting, passively consuming content is the most common approach. Most of the material is designed to be consumed, requiring almost no active participation. Think YouTube or Netflix, where you don't even need to select the next video or episode to watch. It just starts playing it for you automatically. So let's explore our guiding question for this lesson together. How can we use our perception to ensure that students are actively participating online? One strong recommendation we make to our instructors is to be perceptive and actively acknowledge students who arrive late to the virtual classroom. It's important to really welcome them, acknowledge them, and give them a very brief summary of where the class is. Otherwise, they enter, get confused, don't know what's going on, and it's pretty easy to click that X and drop out and never come back. Unlike in an offline environment where it might be kind of awkward to stand up and leave the classroom. If that's too much of a distraction for you as the instructor, you can also ask one of your active students to help with that, keeping an eye out for latecomers and welcoming them. To overcome the lack of visible activities online, it's also good to walk your students through things you're doing. For instance, telling them, "Okay, everyone, within the next minute, I'm going to upload those files we're working on. Take that time for some non-digital recovery, like having a stretch or taking 5 deep breaths."